Oh, hello. Glad you popped in, because today we're going a bit dotty. We're going to make a box full of glass dots. Hello, I'm Jill, this is FiredGlass, and today I've got the bead box out because I want to talk to you about making beads, or dots. Some people call them dots, because I guess they're not really beads, they don't have a hole in the middle. They're simply round little dots of glass, but they are extremely useful for glass fusing. You can find uses in all sorts of projects. So this is how I keep mine. I can tend to differentiate them by colour. I have the transparent set on top, and I have a layer underneath which has got all my opal beads in. So really useful. Try not to drop it. Did it once, didn't like it. Okay, so let's look at how you make beads and some of the rules that you can employ in glass fusing to help you with this. We use scrap glass, as you probably are aware by now. Nothing ever goes to waste in glass, and this is what we're looking for. So we're looking for little round beads like that. So it's going to start off like this. Doesn't have to be massive. You can make beads, as you can see, whatever size you want. But the rule that you're going to employ is something called the 6mm rule. So what's the 6mm rule? Well, when glass is full fused, you will find that the glass behaves in a specific way. It wants to be 6mm thick, hence 6mm rule, and it also wants to go round. It's a bit like mercury, really. So these pieces here that I'm showing you, this piece of glass will look like that once it's been full fused. Same here and same here. So this is 3mm thick glass. It will pull itself up to 6mm, and in doing so it will round off the edges. So this is why when you full fuse anything, it curves those edges and rounds them off. If I was to do this and put two 3mm pieces together, you can see that I've already got that height of 6mm. So it'll still round off, it'll still melt together, but you may not get as good a circle as you do if you're just doing it with 3mm thick pieces. That works for me, works in our kiln. I tend to fuse it at a slightly hotter rate than the standard program. We'll talk about that when we go to the kiln, but I find it gives me a better rounded bead at the end of it. Okay, so let's see what we do with the scrap then. If you've ever bought frit in a tub this size, you can see they're really handy tubs. Don't throw them away. Keep hold of them for your scrap glass. I have one always on the go with my scrap pieces in here, so you can see it's pretty full. But also, because we're going to use these are mosaic nippers that we're going to use. When you use mosaic nippers, generally you have the blades on top and you have them facing downwards. And if I hold them over here, perfect, it's going to keep hold of my glass. So let me show you what I mean by that. So this breaks my heart. This is my box of sadness. This is pieces that have actually been dropped or knocked or for some reason have become broken. So this used to be a lovely wave. It's now going to be a whole series of beads. So if you've got your nippers, just pop them over the top of a bottle like this. If you haven't got that, you can actually buy things that fit onto mosaic nippers that allow you to catch pieces. But I find these bottles are perfect. And you can just snap away. And if the piece is too big, so the piece I've just snipped off looks like this. If you find that it's a bit irregular or too big, you can just take that, snap that in the middle. So that will make a nice large bead, but it'll all round off and give you a nice sort of mixture of those blues and the clear. So that's ideal size. So we've got a tub full of chopped pieces. I've spent hours going through a box doing this, but this is good for now. Let's go to the kiln and see what we can do with these. I'm going to use my hobby fuser for this because it's empty and ready to go. So we've got a kiln washed shelf, but I'm also going to use this. So a lot of people quite often say, what can I do with my scraps of thin fire that are left? Never throw them away because they're ideal for this situation. The shelf is kiln washed, but if I put opaque beads on that or opaque glass on that, like this kind of stuff, so white is notorious for this, for sticking to a kiln shelf. Once it's fused and become a bead, on the bottom of it, it will lift the kiln wash off. And the only real way of getting that off is probably sanding that off if it's quite severe. You can often put them in a solution of vinegar and water. Sometimes works, sometimes doesn't. So I'd rather not do that. I'd rather spend my time laying them out on thin fire paper, the opal ones on thin fire paper. So I've got a few spaces here that I'm going to finish off with all of my opal beads. So the opal's on thin fire, and where we've got spaces on the just kiln washed shelf, these pieces are from a tea light actually that was broken. So they are transparent on the bottom. They've got colour on the top, but they're transparent on the bottom. So I'm going to put those into the spaces left on my kiln washed shelf, and that's it. I'm okay, I can start my full fuse process. So, full fusing then. These program sheets or firing schedules are available from the Warm Glass website. And you'll notice on here they've got basic full fuse, slumping, basic tack. The basic full fuse program, great for this, except I know with my kiln it needs to be a bit hotter. I like my beads to be nice and round rather than just, they will have a flat base, but they're much rounder if you go to a slightly higher temperature. So I modify this for my kiln. Now it's not to say it's going to be the same for yours, so I would just increase this 5 degree increments as you test how your kiln fires, but I know that if I use 815 degrees centigrade, it works for me. But just experiment and see what works best for you. I know this works, I know we're going to get some lovely beads from this. So full fuse schedule should give you some nice round beads. So let's close the kiln and then see what we get in the morning. Okay, so our full fuse program has finished, so it's time to open the kiln, see what we've got. You want to have a look? Woohoo! Okay, so we have a kiln full of dots and a couple of sample pieces that we fire to show what the marina looks like. So these look pretty cool. There's a few that have actually merged together and created some interesting shapes. So we'll have a little look at those. It's quite cool. What I just want to show you here, I've got a wet wipe here. You remember we talked about using thin fire paper, and we talked about just fusing directly onto the shelf. So the ones that are directly onto the shelf, when you look at that, you can see they're totally clear. You might just want to give them a wipe, there's a little bit of dust maybe. But totally clear, no lifting of the kiln wash. So they're absolutely fine, they can go straight into the box. And then the ones that we put on the thin fire paper, so when you look at this, almost clear. And if I just wipe that, you can see very gently needed to wipe that. That's just dust, it's thin fire dust. So nothing is actually baked into that that's going to need, sanding off or anything. So what I do is I just pick these out, drop them in a little bit of water, swish them around to give them a wash, and that's it. They need to go in the bead box. One thing I would say about thin fire paper is that it obviously burns away to dust. So you just need to make sure that once you've got the beads out, and when if you're disturbing the thin fire or you want to sweep it up afterwards, make sure you wear a mask because you don't want to be breathing in any of that dust. But that's it. Got a kiln full of dots. We need to sort them out into colours now, so I better crack on. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed that. I hope it was useful. Don't forget to hit the button with the little bell icon to be notified of any other videos that we upload, and don't forget to subscribe as well. And maybe let us know in the comments how you got on with firing your dots. Maybe see you next time, hey? Thanks for watching. Bye.